In this video, we're going to integrate exponential functions. So in the green here, you have what's in your logbook with regards to integrating exponential functions. So the first one here, it's just if we're integrating e to the power of x. And if we're integrating e to the power of x, we just get e to the power of x. So there's no change, but we also have to add in the plus c. Okay. Next one then. If we're integrating e to the power of some number x, what we do is, first of all, put 1 over whatever that number is, and then we multiply it by e to the power of ax, and of course, put in the c. Last one then, if we're integrating some number to the power of x, that would become some number to the power of x on top, divided by the natural log of that number. Plus C. Right. Again, make sure to have your logbook out in front of you for all of these when you're doing it. So the best thing I can do is go through some questions. So the first one, we want to integrate e to the power of 3x. Okay, well that's handy enough. That would become, we'll have a look first of all at 3x. So the number in front of the x is 3, so it'll be 1 over 3, basing that off this one, okay, because look, I have e to the power of some number x, which is the same as this here. So it's 1 over 3, and then e to the 3x, and of course, don't forget my c. Okay, the next one then. So there's two parts to this. So the first part is I'm going to integrate this, and then the second, I'll integrate this. Right, so first of all, check your exponent, it's 4x, so we will have, in the first instance, 1 over 4, multiplied by e to the 4x, so that's the first bit done, so that is that bit done. And then we'll integrate the 6x. So the 6x integrated will become plus 6x and increase the power by 1. So that was an invisible 1, that's a 2. And then divide everything by what the new power is, which is 2. That can be simplified to 1 over 4e, 4x. Plus 3x squared plus c. Okay, we always add in our plus c. Technically, I suppose, maybe I should have added it up here as well. Okay, next one. Again, we'll take our first bit, the e to the 5x, and that would be 1/5 e to the 5x. Plus 2 integrated is just 2x. And then we have a plus c. The last one then. We take this bit first, this e to the x. E to the x integrated will become just e to the x. Okay, and just for the sake of this, see this minus x here? Well, let's just make it easier. We'd say minus 1x. Okay. Might make it a little bit easier just to think of there's a, it's a minus 1x instead of minus x. So that's plus. So it's 1 over minus 1 e to the power of minus 1x plus c. Okay, I can redo that, simplified. That's it done, by the way, but I can simplify it a bit. E to the power of x plus e minus 1x over minus 1 plus c. Okay, nearly done. Again, we could leave it like that, but just look here. E to the power of x plus. Now, if we look at this, e to the power of minus 1x, well, that's the same as 1 over e to the x over minus 1. Okay, so see what I've done there? Let's go back again. This bit here. That's the same as 1 over e to the 1x r. On the right side, 1 over e to the x. Okay, that's our rules of indices. And that's all over again, the minus 1 here. Minus 1 plus c. Okay, and this then, this bit here, well, that can be simplified because there's only a minus 1 on the bottom. So instead of having the minus 1 on the bottom, I'm just going to put the minus here, get rid of that minus 1, plus c. Okay, so that's that done, guys. Thank you.